As a leader in education, you understand the importance of keeping your students safe online. But when approaching a new technology, you might be wondering, where do I begin? Keeping track of new legal guidelines may seem a little daunting. Luckily, you don't have to be a digital privacy or safety expert in order to make smart and informed choices about what technology you bring into your school. You just need to remember to look for some of the key pieces of the puzzle. There are three separate but connected categories that you need to consider: privacy, safety, and security. This first video covers privacy. Objectives. By the end of this unit, you will be able to define privacy policy, explain the basics of privacy compliance for tech products in education, and identify the key elements needed in privacy assessment for technology in education. As a leader in education, you probably understand the importance of protecting student privacy. After all, you've been safeguarding student records and personal information for years. But understanding new laws governing emerging technologies is unfamiliar territory. Here are some things you'll need to look for when reviewing a new tech product's privacy practices. You'll first need to ask, has this product been reviewed for educational use? Will students be using the product? What are the perceived benefits and risks that this product poses to your students? The first step in protecting your students will be to make conscious choices about what kinds of tools would be best for both them and your school. What age are the students? Many products require adult consent for use by students under the age of 13. This is partially because the Children's Online Privacy Protection Act, COPPA, prohibits tech companies from collecting or using children's data without parental consent. Luckily, this law also allows schools to provide this consent if the product is being used only for educational purposes, if the technology company does not gather information for commercial reasons, for example. In fact, federal law provides many unique protections for children under the age of 13. Next, you'll need to focus on what types of information are being shared. If any of it can be considered sensitive or can be used to identify a student personally, you'll need to keep it in mind when you review the privacy policy. So, does the product have a clearly displayed privacy policy? These policies notify the user of the company's privacy practices and explain how information will be collected, used, shared, and protected. You should only use companies that post privacy policies. However, you shouldn't assume that any company with a privacy policy is safe to use. Despite the namesake, these policies primarily exist to protect the company from legal liabilities, not necessarily the privacy of the users. Reviewing the privacy policy is very important, as there are many things you'll need to be sure are included. Foremost, you'll need a description of all the data that will be collected or maintained, noting who has access to the information and how they will use it, taking into account both the company employees and third-party service providers whose terms of service you haven't agreed to, an acknowledgement that the school can review, control, have deleted, or refuse to provide any information, what procedures they have established in case of a data breach, and how to contact the operator regarding privacy practices. The last thing you'll need to look for is certainly not the least important. You should ask, are there any advertisements in the product? Many internet companies, particularly those that don't charge fees, base their business model on access to data. Personal data can be, and frequently is, used for commercial purposes, most often in the form of advertisements. Some advertising is general. It is displayed for many or all users, regardless of who they are. Online, however, many ads are targeted. They appear selectively based on digital information collected about users. While it is not always illegal for products to display ads, the use of student data by technology companies for targeted advertising is highly prohibited for students of any age. Once you have taken a full look into the company's privacy practices, you should then begin a safety review.